Hello and welcome everyone. In this video I will be making the Spinosaurus mangrove diorama. I will be covering all steps to get to this finished result. We will start the build with a board of multiplex. On top of this, I will be placing some dense foam as the foundation. I already cut them into sizable pieces and then glue them onto the board. With the foam attached, I then create some areas of depth onto the board. I've used a hobby blowtorch to do this. As the next step, I'm using some modeling clay to make a transition between the layers. The sides of the board were then given a layer of wood filler and sanded afterwards. I'm then adding the first layers of primer onto the board. I'll be using these gesso primers to do this. The underside of the board is then given a layer of wood stain. No one will ever notice, but you know it's there, and that's what matters. I've also added a few felt pads to give it some stability. The base is then given a layer of PVA glue, followed with some fine sand and tau grout. This will create a strong foundation and will also provide lots of grip for future layers. The base is then coated with a layer of acrylic roll under. With the first steps of the base completed, I then start making the mangrove trees. I'll be using some of these natural branches to begin with. Using some florist wire and paper clips, I attach the branches onto each other. As the adhesive, I've used some super glue. I gradually add more branches and make a few tree armatures. To fill in the gaps, I'm adding some wood filler followed with tau grout for some texture. To begin painting the trees, I start by priming them black, followed with some light gray. The trees are then given some color by adding a few natural-looking color tones. An acrylic sepia wash is then added to blend in the colors. To create some spots of lichen onto the trees, I've mixed a bit of pigment powder with some water. It's then added onto this fine tea strainer and applied onto the trees using my airbrush. This will give it a random splatter effect. As the foliage for the mangrove trees, I'll be using these natural preserved plants. A special thanks to Diorama Precipe for providing these nice looking materials. The foliage is added onto the branches using PVA glue. I always like to work with natural products, and I thought these worked really well to simulate that typical lush mangrove foliage. With the trees made, I then start making the ground cover. I'm combining some acrylic paste, sand, and paint as the first part. Alongside this, I make a second batch with some of this cork material added. This is basically some leftover cork board that I've ground in a blender. With the mixtures ready, I then apply them onto the base. I start with the paste mixture and then add the coarser mixture on top of this. To create a texture of loose mud and clay, I scatter it loosely over the base and don't press it too firmly. With the paste still wet, I then start adding the trees onto the base. To hold everything in place, I then add a generous amount of scenery glue over this. The cork material will soak up the glue nicely, so it will be quite strong while still retaining that loose texture. As the next step, I'm clipping some bits of the branches I had left over. These will be used to simulate those upright standing roots you see in mangroves often. You could keep it light and add a handful of them, but if you add more, then you basically get extra points. I added quite a few of them at the lower part of the base. I also made this little area as if something large had been crashing through it. Alongside these, I'm adding some of these dried roots and also a few of these tiny mangrove newborns that I've made. Adding trees at different stages of their life cycle can be a nice way to add a bit of character to your diorama. As the next step, I'm adding some of these tiny seashells around the base. They don't scale really well, but I was able to find a few extra tiny ones to use. I've used them to represent some tiny crustaceans crawling around at low tide. To add some more plant life, I'm using some of these preserved leaves and mosses. I will place a link in the description of this video if you wish to find these materials. With all the scenery in place, I can then add the model onto the base. I've chosen this Spinosaurus model, which I gave a custom mangrove repaint. Probably not an accurate representation of Spinosaurus, but I'm just a big fan of the one used in the Jurassic Park franchise. To prepare the base for some resin water, I'm adding a few strips of masking tape. I'm using two-part epoxy resin mixed with some resin tints to give it some color. Using masking tape with casting resin isn't always ideal, but for relative shallow resin pores, such as in this instance, it can work fine. After giving this plenty of time to harden, I'm then using this product to add some water ripples on the surface. As the final step, I go over the sides with some acrylic black paint. With this step done, the diorama is finished, and this brings us to the end of this video. As always, many thanks to my patrons for helping support this channel. I really hope you've enjoyed watching this video, and to see you in the next one. Until then, thank you for watching and take care.